Welcome back to Upfront. People for and against passenger rail in Wisconsin are weighing in big numbers on competing Facebook pages. Much of the effort to save the train is coming from Madison, where it's being led by Mayor Dave Cieslewicz. And he joins us now from our affiliate, WKOW-TV. Mayor, thanks very much for being with us today. On this broadcast...
Mike, thanks for having me.
On this broadcast just a few moments ago, Scott Walker said he is absolutely certain that the project between Milwaukee and Madison is dead, that it's dead, that there's really nothing else to talk about. When you hear comments like that, why do you still hold out hope for this project?
Well, I've listened closely to what the governor-elect has said. First of all, let me congratulate him for winning. He will be the governor of all the people come January, and so that includes Madison and Milwaukee and places in between. And what the governor said is that he opposes high-speed rail, but I have not heard him say that he wants to give the money back to the federal government. What I've heard him say is that he would like instead to get permission to spend the money on roads. And I think that he needs to be convinced that that's just not going to happen, that if you don't spend the money on high-speed rail in Wisconsin, it's going to be spent on high-speed rail, but those jobs will be created in New York or Illinois or Florida. And so I think once he understands that, then we've got an opportunity to have further discussions.
So contrary to what he said, you do not believe this project is dead. You still think there is hope for it?
I do. I have been on the phone talking to the White House, talking to the federal DOT, talking to business leaders in my community and in other parts of the state. You know, this is a very popular project among the business community here in Madison. And I think it's because they understand it's going to put people to work. You know, it's going to create at least 400 jobs right off the bat, almost literally tomorrow, in Jefferson County, where the unemployment rate is 7.5%, once we get the go-ahead. It'll create over 5,000 construction jobs later on over the course of the project. And more importantly, it'll literally put us on the map, the entire state, as a place that welcomes new investment, new ideas, high-tech technologies. It will really help transform the image of the state in a global sort of way. If you look at other vibrant economies like China and Europe and Japan, they're all investing in these high-speed rail systems, and we need to be part of that.
The governor-elect says, in response to that line of logic, he says, you can see any poll. Most of the people in the state of Wisconsin don't want the project, and simply we can't afford it. What do you say to that?
Well, I think that if people understood what this project could mean, if you ask them, do we want to send 5,000 to 10,000 good-paying jobs to New York or Illinois, I think you'd get a different answer. If you explained it in terms of what it could do for our image in terms of economic development in the long run, I think you'd get a different answer. So again, I think it's a question of how you would phrase that question.
Do you have any options if indeed he will not accept the money and the money goes elsewhere? Do you really have any options to keep this fight alive?
Well, you know, the federal government has told me, and they've told others, that they want to continue to work on this project in Wisconsin. They think it is an important link on the Midwest high-speed rail network. Actually, not just Chicago to Milwaukee to Madison, but Chicago to Milwaukee to Madison to the Twin Cities. So it is important for the entire Midwest high-speed rail network that they do this. And so I'm continuing to sense really strong support for this in Washington. And among, again, the business community, especially here in Madison, but also in other places. And no, look, if we can't get the new administration to join us as a partner in this, it's going to be very tough to do it anytime soon. But I have not given up on that.
Bottom line, as they always say, elections matter. And in this case, the Democrats lost, the Republicans, and Scott Walker won. He's doing exactly what he said he would do. This really shouldn't come as a surprise to any of you, should it?
Well, again, exactly what he said he'd do is try to get the money spent on roads. He did not say that he wanted to give the money back to the federal government just so they could build exactly the same kind of project in New York or Illinois or some other state. So, again, I think once he understands what the parameters are and what the restrictions are in terms of how that money can be used, he very well may come to a much different and, I would say, better conclusion.
All right, Mayor Dave Cieslewicz, we appreciate your time again today. Thanks very much for being with us on Upfront.
Thanks for having me.
Next on Upfront, the state and size of Wisconsin's deer herd heading into hunting season.
Who is Wisconsin's fastest rising Republican star? When Upfront continues.